Thank you. Bonjour et bienvenue au notre concert. Hello and welcome to this specially broadcast concert. It's such a shame that we can't be there in person to explore your beautiful town and perform for you in Sackville. But thanks to the wonders of modern technology, we can at least offer you this concert tonight. We've been lucky enough to be given permission to perform here in the Temple Church, right in the centre of London. It's one of London's most historic and interesting buildings. It was built in the 12th century by the Knights Templar, who were an order of crusading knights founded to protect pilgrims on their way back from Jerusalem, and also to defend Jerusalem for Christendom as well. The part that we're performing in tonight is the Round Church, which is the oldest part, and it was built to echo the Church of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem. Our programme has two strands running through it. One is the music of Josquin des Prez. Josquin was born in somewhere near the border of modern-day France and Belgium, and he was one of the most influential composers in the history of music. 2021 is the 500th anniversary of his death, and we've really been enjoying the excuse to get to know a bit more of this amazing music of his. The other strand is all music that was written for the devotion and worship of the Virgin Mary. Marian devotion really took off in the 16th century, and Mary inspired some of the greatest works of art and music from that period. The next three pieces that we're going to perform all have a link to the Virgin Mary. Clemens Nonpapa's beautiful Ego Flos Campi sets a text from the Song of Songs, but it has a link with Mary because he worked for a time for a Marian Brotherhood in a Dutch town with an unpronounceable name. And he worked for this Marian Brotherhood, and their motto was Sicut Lilium inter Spinas, like a lily among thorns. And you can hear in this setting of the text that in the middle of the piece, he really sets those words in simple homophony, so you can really hear their motto coming out through the music. The next piece is Josquin's lovely, beautiful, simplistic setting of Ave Maria, the words from the Annunciation that the angel Gabriel speaks to Mary. And then finally, we have Peter Phillips's Gaudi Virgo Maria. Peter Phillips was born in England, but was forced to flee to the continent because of his Catholic faith. So he couldn't practice his Catholic faith openly in England. So he moved to all around Europe for a while and settled eventually in Belgium, where he became very successful as a musician.
Thank you. As Helen mentioned, the music of Josquin des Prez is the linchpin of our programme to commemorate the 500th anniversary of his death. We don't know much about his biography, but we do know that he was born in northern France and throughout his lifetime worked in Avignon, Paris, Milan, Rome and Ferrara before returning to northern France at the beginning of the 1500s, where he spent the rest of his life. We can say, however, that he was the first superstar composer. His style bridged the gap between the medieval and Renaissance, and the advent of music printing meant that his music was disseminated and widely known within his lifetime. Even Martin Luther said that he was the master of notes. The Virgin Mary was an inspiration for many of his finest works, and it's that music that we're focusing on this evening. You've already heard the Salve Regina, which uses the four first notes of the antiphon chant as a motif, which we hear 24 times throughout the piece, and then the more intimate and heartfelt Ave Maria, possibly his most famous piece of music. Next, we're going to hear Virgo Salutiferi, which has three virtuosic male voices interspersed between a cantus firmus in canon between the soprano and tenor parts. And the cantus firmus sings the Ave Maria Grazia Plena. We'll then hear an intimate setting by William Byrd of that Ave Maria text again. Then finally, for Josquin, we'll hear his Inviolata, which is one of his finest pieces and uses cascading melodies to describe the Immaculate Conception and again shows his fondness for canons, this time between the alto and the baritone.
Thank you. Thank you. Our final piece is John Taverner's Ave Dei Patris Filia. Taverner was the first director of music at what is now Christ Church Cathedral, Oxford, and his music represents the last flowering of late medieval polyphony, which was rudely interrupted by the English Reformation. It's a votive antiphon in praise of the Virgin Mary, and the text is particularly colourful and effusive in praise of her. It's a substantial piece of around 18 minutes long, with lots of solo sections, large choruses, and, as is stylistic for a votive antiphon of this period, an amen that seems to go on for eternity. We hope you've enjoyed this concert, and we very much hope that we'll have the opportunity to perform in person for you in the future.
Oh.